everybody. Welcome back to week two.
Week two. Dose. Viruses.
Deuces. Viruses. Last week, let's just go through a little bit of what we went through. Again, if you don't remember, maybe this is your first time tuning in. My name is Dr. Kaylee, and this is...
And I'm Dr. James.
Dr. James. We are a brother and sister team. We live in a Chicagoland area in St. Charles, Illinois, and we have been serving our community for the last 13 years. And we're so excited to bring you this masterclass series. Again, this is week two. Week one was really an introductory of everything that we're going to be going through. So tell us some things that we talked about last week.
We just literally did our live class yesterday with about 60 people, and it was a great, great day. We talked about the five essentials and introducing these five essentials into your life so your body can be in alignment with health.
Yep.
And understanding what health is. And really our purpose here in doing all of these videos for you is to empower you to take control back of your health. That is what we wake up every morning praying for an answer for you guys to help apply these things to your life.
Yeah, it's just really neat for us to be able to continually see people coming in with no answers, coming in saying that they've been praying for a different way, for some hope, for something to believe in. And you know, that's really what we're doing these talks for, is to be able to give you a chance to maybe just have some hope for the first time in a few years.
Well, we're an innately sick country. You know, we lead the world, and we went through all those statistics last week. I won't go through them again, but we lead the world in disease. And it's up to us as people to be the change to those statistics, to be those change, not just in America, but in your family. Because health is the most important thing to me, to Dr. Kaylee, and it should be to you, because once you lose your health, you lose everything. And right now, people are so scared of this coronavirus because, again, I think it's ignorance, it's lack of knowledge, it's people not understanding how the body functions and how it heals and how it naturally can overcome these things drug-free.
Yeah, and so we really just want you to go from being told that you're a victim and be empowered to become a victor. And that really just takes, again, we're going to go through mindset on every single one of these weeks, because it takes a total mindset shift, and it takes an understanding of what your body was made and designed for. And it's not made and designed to break down constantly over time. It's actually made to survive these types of things.
Yeah, exactly. And I'm so excited that we're going to be talking about the germ theory right now, because it really has laid the foundation for how we are responding to this virus and to any virus that's out there, whether it be the flu or the chickenpox or whatever. We go off of this one theory that this man, Louis Pasteur, made back in 1895 or the 1800s. He died in 1895. And, you know, he said that basically the germ theory states that when a microbe or a germ or a pathogen enters the body, the replication of that microbe or pathogen or germ or virus causes sickness. You know, he was friends with another man named Claude Bernard, and it was one of his colleagues. And Claude Bernard actually flipped the script on him and said, hey, I really don't think it's just simply the microbe. I think it actually has to deal with the terrain or the body itself, the host. So if a virus or bacteria or microbe enters the host and that host is sick, then it will start to replicate, because it's an opportunistic thing that's inside the body. It will start to replicate and cause symptoms and sickness. If the host is healthy, Bernard said, then those microbes will not flourish. They cannot flourish because we have an innate immune system inside of us that can help the body function. So back then in 1895, it wasn't a coincidence that some of the first chiropractors, actually the first two chiropractors, went off of those theories. And Dr. B.J. Palmer said that, I desire to know why one person was ailing and the associate eating at the same table, working at the same shop, at the same bench, was not. Why? That's a question that chiropractic was founded upon. Why do I get sick? Why is one person in the same household always getting the flu and all the other people seem not to be stricken by it? Why is the question? What difference was there in the past two persons that caused one to have the various disease while his partner escaped that disease? And then his son went on to say that if the germ theory was correct, the germ theory of disease was correct, there'd be no one living to believe it, because basically these microbes that are constantly hovering around us and on our skin, they're on our skin right now. Streptococcus is in my throat right now. It's in your throat right now. And again, these things are normal flora. It's a normal part of our body, and it's constantly in battle every single second of our life on our skin and in our bodies itself. Our gut, which Dr. Kaylee's going to talk about, contains a bunch of billions of strands of bacteria and viruses that are in there. And again, our bodies need these things to thrive. But when our bodies become out of balance, that's when they start to take over and cause symptoms. And that's when they cause disease. So let's go through the immune system. Because again, Dr. B.J. Palmer said if the germ theory was correct, there'd be no one alive to believe it, because they'd all be dead because all these viruses and bacteria would have already killed us. So he laid the foundation to something that's inside of us that's controlling sickness and health. And that's the immune system. And there's actually something controlling the immune system itself, and that's the nervous system. So we've got to go back to that. What causes the immune system to function properly? Why is it functioning properly? And why, again, the question chiropractic was founded upon, why are people sick? We have to understand that the immune system is an intricate system of cells that are constantly communicating chemically to get to these viruses and bacteria, to gobble them up before they start to gobble you up. So again, the immune system, if your body is healthy and functioning properly, you don't have to worry about the viruses. You know, we've come up with this word, we haven't come up with it, but it's been in the forefront of our minds right now, comorbidity. And the studies show that only 6% of the people that have passed away from coronavirus had no diseases, no underlying diseases. Most have two or more diseases. So what does that mean? That means that if your body is already sick with diabetes, with cancer, with heart disease, or with anything that suppresses the immune system, the reason the immune system is suppressed is because your body's trying to fight all of the sugar that you're eating. It's trying to fight the diseased heart. It's trying to repair those things. That's the most important thing right now, not the microbe that's trying to invade you. So again, if your body and system was functioning properly, then the immune system and all those cells and tissues and organs can function properly as well.
You know, and it's a system, right? It's not just something that, oh, like we've got this thing that's going to go out and fight. Like there's literally blood cells that are activated the second that an antigen comes in and your body starts to fight. You know, the fever is happening because it's literally trying, your body is trying to kill something that's trying to attack it. And so this whole system is extremely, extremely intricate. And like Dr. James had said, he kind of went into some of these things that we're going to go into now, but the gut. Your gut has everything to do with your immune system. If you're not treating your gut well, then your immune system is not functioning well. There's almost 70%, there's over 70% of your immune system that is actually located in your gut. So what's your gut? It's your stomach, it's your digestive system, it's your bowels and bladder and all these things that are digesting your food. So here's the deal. If you're eating these foods that are destroying your gut, destroying your lining, destroying the microbes that are actually living inside of your gut, these good, we call them there's the good pathogens versus the bad pathogens. And there's ones that are going to attack and do bad things, but there's ones that live inside of your gut that are actually providing a house and a system for your body to live and thrive in. It's a place where your immune system starts to work. And so if you're eating these bad foods and more the bad microbes have to take over the good microbes land, and then all of a sudden your immune system gets shut down and your body can't heal and function. And so one good way to do that, to think about this, is eating whole foods, is eating fruits and vegetables, it's eating grass-fed, free-range, organic meats. And what that's going to do is it's going to provide an environment that's suitable for your body to function and heal. The flip side of that is continuing to eat processed foods and continuing to eat the sugars and continuing to eat the things. And I'm going to go way into more depth of all this as I go through this, but these foods that you're deciding and choosing to put into your body does have a direct reflection of what your health actually is. And so when we do the comparison in the studies between the comorbidities versus and the viruses, you know, it's just, there's no doubt about it that if you are overweight, if you've got heart disease, if you've got diabetes, if you've got a weakened immune system, or what we've learned now is a compromised immune system is what they're talking about. If you've got high blood pressure, if you've got anything, any one of those things going on, that means that your body's already in a broken down state. And so the problem that I have with this is that what we're doing is, instead of let's have a conversation of how do we strengthen and build up the immune system, what we're doing is how do we hide and shield ourselves from these things and not actually walk into this battle and take it head on. You know, when we talk about the germ theory and how we live our lives, the reason why we can walk out into the public in these days right now and not have an issue with coming in contact with this is because we know how our body works and how it was designed to fight these things. Over my 34 years and Dr. James's 38 years, we've built an immune system that is fearless because of different things that we put into our lives. You know, growing up, I remember going to my uncles who were chiropractors when I was quote unquote sick. And we don't like to even call it sick. We like to say that our body is expressing health, because if you're fighting something off, then your body's actually expressing a healthy symptom. And so my uncle used to come over and get me adjusted. We used to go to the chiropractor. And I remember driving in the car with mom one time and like, why do we go to the chiropractor when we're sick? And for her, like, her response was just so natural. And she's not a chiropractor, but my dad's family was all chiropractors. And that's how we learned this. And she's like, I don't really know, but I know that this is the right thing to do. And so we want to teach you what that was and why she was deciding to do this. Because like Dr. James is going to go into in even more depth, the nervous system is the exact thing that controls everything in your body. And so when we talk about, so Dr. Kaylee, Dr. James, how do you live your lives fearlessly and not being afraid of everything that's going on around us? You know, the pandemic, this whole thing didn't really shake us too much. It got me worried about other people that weren't prepared and ready for this. But it didn't really shake me. I never had like a scared feeling of coming in contact or even contracting the virus, because I know my body's going to fight it. I know the work that I've done. So here's these five things that we're going to be talking about over the next 6 weeks of the five essentials. And so we've got number one, which is core chiropractic. This is who we are. This is what we do. This is what we grew up on. We've got nutrition, we've got mindset, we've got oxygen and exercise, and we've got detoxification. Whenever I have anything going on, or if I know that I'm going to be going into a war space, I want to make sure that I've got all five of these things intact and ready to go. And the first of these is chiropractic. And what's really cool is right before this adjustment, Dr. James was like, I need you to adjust me.
Yeah.
And so he got an amazing chiropractic adjustment, releasing the interference off of his nervous system, allowing his body to go back to work.
We talked about last week how some people get in the trap of going to chiropractors just because they're in pain. I wasn't in any pain. I just know as soon as she adjusted me, a lot of different things happened chemically inside of my body. Pressure was released from my brainstem. She adjusted my atlas so the brain can communicate properly through my spinal cord and out through my nerves and into my organs, cells, and tissues. Organs, cells, and tissues. Cells are the things that create your immune system. They're cells. And there's a chemical reaction, like I said, that happens every single time you get adjusted. There's been studies that show that this thing called interleukin-2 increases 200% every single time people get adjusted. 200%. And interleukin-2 is the precursor that controls your white blood cells. And your white blood cells are the things that go out and find those things like viruses and bacteria and germs and the microbes that we're talking about today. So again, if my nervous system is compressed, if my body cannot function, if my brain cannot communicate to those cells to tell them what to do and how to search for these viruses, then those viruses start to multiply and start to take over the body and start to cause symptoms. So that's what we're here to do. It's not about taking pressure off the nervous system because you're in pain. It's about making sure that your body and your nervous system is in the proper position every single day of your life. We don't go now to get adjusted again because we're in pain. I get adjusted to keep my body functioning properly, to remove the interference to the body's own healing ability. Again, we're innately sick, because we don't know how innately amazing our nervous system is. That's the missing link, I believe, into most people's health journey, is the nervous system itself. And we have to understand that when I went to school, I had amazing chiropractic care my entire life. And as soon as I went to school, they take x-rays of you to make sure that they understand what your spine and nervous system looks like so you can educate other people on what proper versus improper is. And when they took an x-ray when I was about 21, 22 years old, my neck was completely straight. I had a military neck. Even though I had been getting adjusted my entire life since the day I was born, I still had a military neck. Now, my family went to school at the time where the structural correction wasn't part of the paradigm. They did not learn that in school. So again, they were just adjusting single segments. Since then, I've researched specific ways and specific molding techniques to help people get their spines back into the proper position. So there's two different types. There's structural correction versus symptom care. Symptom care is the most popular that people go to chiropractors for. Structural care, a lot of people don't understand or don't know about it. So that's what we're here to teach you today. So what did I do? I researched and I went to elective courses to understand how to get this curve back into my neck, because I understood that this curve that was not there, that pressure that's on those discs were causing degeneration, causing them to fuse together. And at 21, I was young enough then to mold the spine back into its proper position pretty quickly to stabilize it and keep it there for the rest of my life. And that's what I do now. Every December 6th, which is my birthday, I get an x-ray to make sure that my spine is in its proper position. And if I've got any weird things popping up laterally, or if I'm starting to lose the curve because of technology and missing some of my home care or whatever it is, traveling a lot, then I get right back on it and make sure that I correct it back into the proper position. And that's the difference. That's what we do in our office. We do structural correction, molding techniques to get people's spine back in the proper position. I took an x-ray of a 75 and 77 year old couple last night, and it almost made me want to cry. And I walked out of that room saying, when are people going to wake up and understand that if their core is rotting, that everything in their body is starting to rot as well? You think about that amazing nervous system that people have. If the bones around it and the discs around it that are supposed to support it and protect it, if that starts to break down and rot, so does that lifeline that people have. You know, and they've got 12 or 13 different medications that they're taking a piece, and that is the norm. You know, but all of those degenerative discs and the degenerative bones that were in their spine is completely preventable if people just understand how to keep the proper position of the spine from birth to death.
So the next thing that we need to go into is nutrition, which is my favorite thing to talk about, because I think that this is the spot where people struggle the most, and you kind of just don't know what's the right decision or what's the wrong decision, or you've kind of just thrown it out the window and you're like, you look at food as a party, and every time that you see food, you just want to have a party.
I think that we started this last week with saying that we want to help you create a relationship with your health and not to overstep her boundaries. But for me, I was just making breakfast up there with some of these things that you see on this picture, and I just enjoy it so much. Just making food, preparing live, healthy food that are full of not just nutrients and minerals and all the things your cells and body needs to thrive, but it's full of information. It's full of what God has designed us to understand, and our body can assimilate this information with live food. We want to help you create a different relationship with your health.
Yeah, so
with your food.
Yes. So when we talk about food, the thing is that for me, I didn't have a good relationship with food until about 9 years ago. I remember the first time when you used to live at Dr. Major's house, and you're like, they cook us organic food, and we were like, what is that hippie stuff? You know, like, we didn't have any idea. For me, like, growing up was salads were a bowl of croutons with ranch dressing, and that was my salad at the salad bar. And so I'm with you. Like, we didn't come out of the womb eating kale chips, and that's where we lived. I've had to grow through this over the last 10, mostly the last 10 years, really in the last 8 or 9 years. And our biggest thing for me was when our mom got sick, she started experiencing symptoms that we couldn't figure out. And food was our way out. Food was what got us to allow her body to start healing and thriving. And so one of the biggest things that I'm most upset about during this, and I hate even talking about it, but during this coronavirus pandemic is the food situation. You know, if it was really truly about your health, why haven't we shut down the fast food restaurants? Why haven't we shut down the ice cream stores and the candy stores that have lines coming out of them with family members standing in line with masks on, because it's good for your health, right? And so when people talk to me about wearing a mask or about doing these things for my health or for the health of others, my response usually is, okay, so let's look at your grocery cart and let's figure out what we can change in your diet so that you don't become a place that's going to house such virus. And so really that's what it's all about. So when we talk about sugar, the way for me to not eat things, because I have food addictions too. I love bags of chips at a time, which are full of sugar and full of all kinds of other stuff. But when we talk about sugar, I want you to think sugar is your immune system danger, like red flags, lights going off. So here's the problem is that sugar creates inflammation. And anytime you have inflammation inside of your body, that's creating an environment that is ready for disease to show up. And so if you, like we talk about this a lot, is if you had a dumpster and you had rats going into the dumpster and they were eating all the garbage, they were going after it. If you took all of the rats away but left the dumpster, within the next day, there's going to be a new set of rats that come in. And so what we need to do is we need to get rid of the garbage. And if you get rid of the garbage, the rats aren't going to come back to an empty dumpster. And so same thing with this is that, you know, sugar has 16 times, is 16 times more destructive towards cancer cells than any other substance on the planet. And when I have people go on these sugar detoxes, it's like they're coming off of a hard street drug. Because the reality is that these I almost just said these drugs, but these foods are as addictive as drugs. You know, sugar is the most readily available substance on the planet. You go to any grocery store, you go to any gas station, you go to anybody's friend's house or grandma's house, and you're bombarded with all of this sugar. So I'm with you. I understand that this is something that's very hard to get away from and give up. But your life is truly depending on it. Your body wants to fight these things, but as soon as you introduce sugar into that, not only is it creating inflammation, but it's also weakening your immune system. And so if you're eating sugar, you're weakening your immune system, then your body's not able to go out and fight the things that it's designed to fight. So within our office, we have really two main plans that we teach our patients. I hate calling them diets. I hate going on this, we're going to put you on a new diet. No, because what I want to do is I want to get you to start shifting into a totally different mindset and a totally different lifestyle. And so when we talk about these two plans, number one is the Max Living Core Plan. And so when I talk about the core plan, this is that plan where if you want to stay healthy, if you've got a family that you just want them to eat healthy food and live a long, good life, this is the plan where you're going to go on to. You're going to reduce some of your sugars. You're going to make sure that you're eating the good types of meat, the organic, grass-fed, wild-caught things. You're going to start to eliminate some of the breads and the grains, but not fully get rid of them. You're still going to have a lot of the beans that we have on these things. You're going to load up with organic fruits, organic vegetables, and your body's just going to be eating. Just really, like, think of this plan of, like, you're just going to start eating real food. You're going to start eating real food. When you go into this next level, which is the hardest one for most people to conceptualize, this is our Max Living Advanced Plan. This is the one where I tell my patients, if you want to reverse diseases, if you want to get off of medications, if you're ready to lose the stubborn weight, this is the plan that you want to go off of. If you want to fight a virus that's causing a pandemic, the advanced plan is the way to go. So you're completely eliminating all sugars, except for two or three fruits that I'll let you have, one of those being grapefruits, one of those being Granny Smith apples, and then the other ones being berries. You're going to completely eliminate your grains. So there's no grain allowed on the advanced plan, because grain, essentially, as soon as it touches the saliva in your mouth, it turns into sugar. Sugar causes inflammation and it destroys the gut microbiome and destroys your immune system. The other thing that you're going to do is you're going to make sure that you're eating organic vegetables, but you've got to kind of limit those to the lower carb, higher fiber, things like that. And so really just sticking into that, this is going to help to drastically reduce inflammation in your body. The next thing is more of what I would say is kind of a fad thing. It's sticking around a lot longer than what most of these things do. And it's a lot like the advanced plan. So people confuse the advanced plan with the keto diet. But one of the biggest things is that you're really focusing on eating heavy, heavy doses of really good healthy fats. And so those numbers are going to be 60 to 70% of fat, 20 to 30% of proteins, and then only 5% of carbohydrates. And so what this is doing, it's creating an environment with almost no inflammation. Really good fat helps you to open up toxic cells, release the toxins from those cells, and allow the body to go back into work. And then the fat is also how your brain works and how it functions. So big things, it's gonna help you lose weight. And this isn't a weight loss conversation, but we know that one of the comorbidities is obesity and being overweight. And so it's gonna help you lose weight, which removes toxins from your body, which ultimately it boosts your immune system. A couple good things to do, there's a really good, if you wanna dive into the ketogenic diet, I recommend trying it for 2 to 4 weeks at first, and if it doesn't respond with your body well, but make sure you are following this 100% to the T, because if you veer off the keto diet, even just a little bit, it quote unquote won't work. And you're not gonna get the results that people say that they get. I recommend getting an app. There's a keto diet app on your phone, on your iPads, that can track everything and keep you accountable. Because that's the biggest thing with this stuff, is that if you get off track even just a little bit, your ketone bodies aren't gonna be there, your fat burning zone will be wasted away, and so it's not gonna be getting rid of the things that you need to be getting rid of.
The great thing about this technology that we have now, applications are everything for me, and it's like my coach. I have something called Real Plans, and it literally plans out my entire week. It puts the grocery list onto Instacart, and I click a button, and my entire week worth of menu shows up at my door, which
awesome.
That's a no-brainer, and it's all good foods. It's the whole 30. That's what I do during the week. So a couple of suggestions that, you know, I don't expect everyone to be on the advanced plan all the time unless you're truly trying to reverse something like heart disease and like cancer. But, you know, I do it intermittently, meaning that sometimes I'm on it and sometimes I'm off it. The weekends, most of the time, I kind of relax and let my body, or let my mouth do what it wants to do with food, when food is concerned. So during the week, I'm 100%. Like last night, I went to dinner. I veered off course a little bit, but now this morning, I got right back on course. I cooked my breakfast. That breakfast is gonna be good for 2 or 3 days, so I don't have to worry about it. So, you know, there's some things you can fluctuate with and do that with. So I don't know if you have any pointers for that.
Yeah. Just one of the big things is that I just see so many people get overwhelmed when it comes to nutrition. And within 2 or 3 days, you throw in the towel. And so just don't overcomplicate this. If you're going to do the advanced plan, commit to it for 2 weeks. Don't say I'm gonna do this for the rest of my life, because it's possible, but it is very difficult in the beginning. So go on. Maybe it's just 1 week or 2 weeks, whatever it is, but commit to a short period and see how good your body feels, and then recommit to another 2 weeks.
If you never cook anything, commit to cooking twice this week, maybe.
Yeah.
You know, so baby steps. I don't want to throw the baby out with the bathwater, but make sure that, again, you're making steps in the right direction. Maybe you're doing 4 or 5 meals a week with the family and teaching your kids how to create, again, a different relationship with their food. And just make it fun, because, again, cooking should be fun. It should not be a burden. And we've gotten so far away from that with these fast food restaurants and these boxed food and pizzas that are so easy, but so harmful for your health. And again, there's a much different experience than having the doorbell ring and a pizza being delivered than you getting up there, cutting food up, and teaching your kids and your family how to make stuff that's actually going to nourish your body and sustain health through a lifetime.
And be okay with failing. I remember when I first moved here, I lived with Dr. James, and we went through our entire nutrition plans book and cooked all the meals in there, and some of them were like awful.
I don't know if the recipe was awful.
We thought it was awful.
Maybe we just cooked it wrong.
We weren't ready, yes.
But we went through it, and now I could call myself an amazing cook,
yes.
And so can she. She's been a raw vegan sometimes intermittently throughout the past 5 or 6 years, and these recipes that she concocts are amazing. They're literally, they taste just like she makes these burgers that taste just like burgers and there's no meat at all.
Yeah.
You know, so get jiggy with it and have fun with it and make sure that you understand, again, food should be something that nourishes you, not something that just fills you.
Let's talk about working out.
I love working out.
He loves working out. I hate working out.
And again, I'm going to talk about working out and toxins and mindset and all this stuff. And it really is the same thing, you know, because again, for me, oxygen and exercise is something that resets my brain. It helps me de-stress and it also helps me detoxify. And studies have shown when it comes to viral loads, studies have shown your killer T cells are activated just after a brisk walk. Some people are gonna say, oh, well, I can just go walk and that's it. And that's not what this is for. We're gonna teach you what max T3 is all about. High intensity, short duration exercises. We did this last week with our team and it was four different exercises that we did. It was called a Tabata. So 20 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Four different exercises times 8. So it was about a 20 minute exercise and they are sore for the next 3 days, you know? So, and again, it's only 20 seconds off, on, you take a 10 second rest with push-ups and sit-ups and different movement of your body, but it's designed to increase the oxygen in your cells, tissues and organs, because an oxygenated environment is really good to kill viruses. And it's also really good to kill cancers. And it also helps increase your testosterone levels. Even in women, it's good because that helps to allow the body to regulate more lean muscle to get the fat off of your body. Testosterone helps melt fat literally right off the body. And it's in men and women, obviously more pronounced in men. But again, we wanna make sure that you're moving the body. Okay, movements that help increase testosterone are squats. So we were doing squats last week and push-ups and full body movements like burpees as well. So I can't stress enough how important exercise is. I don't think walking is exercise. Walking will help, but we want to make sure that you start to, again, do these high intensity, short duration exercises for 12 to 15 minutes a day.
So don't hear what he's not saying. Again, this isn't a bad, like if you don't work out, if you can't even barely get up and walking is going to be a huge thing for you, then walking for you is an exercise.
Right.
But don't stop there. Go get cans in the kitchen and start doing some curls. Put them over your head. Lean against the wall and do some push-ups. Stop limiting yourself from what you think that you can't do and start pushing through those barriers because there's so much more on the other side of that barrier than what you're allowing yourself to believe that there is.
I think we said this last week and I think I got it right, even though she said I got it wrong, but if you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl. If you can't crawl, roll over. And if you can't roll over, flutter or do something. You just, again, the point is to get moving. Get oxygen in your blood and start to help the body to function properly from the inside out.
Get moving.
It's also minimizing toxins. Exercise. If you sweat, that means toxins are literally coming right out of your fat cells. Okay, so we want to understand that we have to minimize the toxins internally and externally through what we're consuming in food and also what we're putting on our skin. I talked briefly about soaps and things that are on our skin. If you put an antibacterial soap on your skin, it literally kills the good bacteria and the bad bacteria. So now it's destroyed the terrain that helps your skin thrive. And it also causes these crazy super bugs that we're creating out there.
Super bugs.
The super bugs like MRSA and all of these other different things. So instead of antibacterial soap, I would move towards regular soap. Studies have shown that there's no more benefit from using antibacterial soap or regular soap. Just make sure that you wash your hands properly. 2 to 3 minutes under that water and scrubbing pretty hard.
I just think it's so funny that in 2020 we have to have signs all over the place that say wash your hands. Like, aren't we past that point?
I mean, I don't know. Have you ever watched a bathroom and people come out that don't want to? I guess it's just laziness, like everything else. But also, check your cleaners, because you put something on your surface, like a countertop that you're cooking your nice, organic, healthy foods with your family. All of that food is absorbing the toxins that you put on that countertop through the cleaning process. So again, we want to check our cleaners. We use essential oils. Young Living is a great product for that. There's many different products out there. Your health food stores have many different products out there. What are some things that you use?
On the spot. Young Living, for the most part, is what I use. Seventh generation, honest.
Vinegar and water. It's just like chemicals in food. If your cleaning products have things in them that you cannot pronounce, stop putting them on your surfaces and on your skin. Same thing with shampoos and other different things that hold all these toxic chemicals that are absorbed right into our system.
There's a really good app for you guys to download. It's called Think Dirty. This is an app that you walk around and like you scan the barcode of your cleaning products and your beauty products, and it tells you green, yellow, or red, and the numbers in between there. So if it's red, it means it's an endocrine disruptor. It's something that you need to get rid of immediately. If it's yellow, it's something that you can maybe kind of hold on to for a little bit longer until you find a really good replacement. If it's green, go ahead and keep it. So Think Dirty app.
Let's move into mindset if we talk about thinking, okay? Because I think that stress is the most toxic thing that you can have. And most people right now, especially, they're chronically stressed. They're in a constant state of fight or flight. They've got cortisol running through their system every single second of their life. And cortisol was meant for your body to become, you know, to run from a bear or something that's trying to kill you. So we are too stressed out and we do not know how to manage peace. We went through last week peace management instead of stress management. I don't really want you to manage something that you don't like. Why would you want to manage your stress? Why don't you bring more peace into your life?
Yes.
So we're going to both go through some techniques that we use just so we can help you, because everyone's different. And I've done a bunch of different morning routines and afternoon routines. Right now, the one that's working for me is I wake up and I move and I drink I drink water right away. Before the coffee, I do drink healthy, natural coffee now. I get into a meditative state and I get into some sort of amazing, what we call the green books, to help my brain start thinking about how I'm going to help my patients. So some sort of cognitive thing, some sort of movement thing, and some sort of thing to get your body flushing through the system.
Yeah, for me, my biggest thing, and I think I talked about this last week also, is I wake up at the same time every single day. No matter if it's Sunday or no matter if it's Wednesday, I'm getting up at the same time to make sure that I have my ample time to do my morning routine. For me, I like to my mornings are quiet. I get my coffee, I get in, start reading in the Bible, I start doing my journaling, and I go through that. I look at my calendar and figure out what's going to happen for the day and for the week. I have another app. We're talking about apps, which is funny because I got rid of my phone, so I don't have any apps. But another app that I use, it's called Google Tasks. I think even on your iPhone or iPad, you can have a reminders app. I just like this other one because it syncs better with your calendar. And this is something that I'll put all the things that I need to get done for the day, and then the week, and then the month. And so I can make sure that I'm going through and checking those off. Otherwise, I forget them, or I'm like, shoot, what was I supposed to remember to do? Something like that.
So I'm an avid CrossFitter, and I love to do it. And I'm in a master's right now because I'm over 35. So I've got a master's program and an app that literally schedules out my week, so I know exactly what to do and when to work out. And the food, you know, the Real Plans app. Apps are great if you use them properly, right? We're not scrolling Instagram and Facebook and all these different things. We're posting this stuff on Facebook so people can learn, but the apps can be used in your
benefit.
You know, so use them wisely. The food plan, the workout plan that I have, the Max T3 workout plan that you guys should all have with the bookmark that we provide you guys. It's all designed to help you reduce stress, because if I had to plan out all that stuff and plan my menu for the week and do all these different things, I would be stressed out beyond belief and I wouldn't know where to turn.
Yeah, so let's talk about some more nutrients again, because a lot of times, again, we talked about this last week, that our food supply is just so low in nutrition, in nutrients, because of our soil, because of the stuff that we're spraying on our food, because of everything that we're doing. And so I always want to make sure that you know that it is supplemental. This is not something that is going to replace a bad diet, a poor diet. This is supplemental. And so one of the biggest supplements, one of the biggest vitamins that we are deficient in is vitamin D3. It says right here that about 42% of the United States population is deficient in vitamin D. If you're watching this and you're in the Midwest and it is October or something, or maybe even later, we are going into winter here, and this is the time where people spend most of their days inside. And the reality is that most of their days have been spent inside since last year, mm-hmm. right? Like, people stayed inside. And so this is true now more than ever before. And where do you get your vitamin D? Vitamin D is made from when the sun contacts your skin, and your body produces the vitamin. Problem is that even if you were to spend your day outside with 60% of your skin exposed, soaking up vitamin D, you have to let that go through your system for at least 24 to 48 hours. The FDA is recommending that we have about 500 IUs of vitamin D on a daily basis. That really right now at this point is not going to really touch anything that's coming at us. What we want to recommend is 10 times that, about 5,000 IUs per day for you to be taking in vitamin D so that your body can boost your immune system and do what it's supposed to.
And that's somebody with a properly functioning body.
Yes.
That's just normal. So if you've got diabetes or cancer or any other disease that's out there, I would ramp that up to 10,000 or even 15,000 IUs per day.
Yes, and another great thing to be supplementing right now too is vitamin C, and this can be something that is taken on a daily basis. So vitamin C, it says supplements may help reduce the duration of illness by 17%. What this does is it goes in for your immune system, and it starts to activate your white blood cells. And those are the guys that are going out and they're fighting the good fight for you. And so these are the ones that are going to be fighting. And so you want to like feed your soldiers, right? Like, you don't want to send a soldier out on an empty stomach. And so you want to feed these soldiers the supplements that they need to go out and fight these things. So for me, on a regular basis, if you weren't fighting an illness, it would be about 2,500 milligrams of vitamin C per day. I would double that if you're starting to feel some symptoms come up. And then almost triple or quadruple that as you're fighting symptoms. They have shown studies that high doses of vitamin C, they're actually doing these intravenously now, are fighting things like cancer. They're fighting different immunology issues. And so this is something that you want to be putting into your system as much as possible. Lifestyle is a thing that decreases your vitamin C. So smoking, alcohol, poor food choices, these are the types of things that are gonna actually be decreasing your vitamin C regularities. And vitamin C is an amazing antioxidant. I know when I drink it, my energy goes through the roof almost immediately.
If I can add something here, yes. With vitamin C and vitamin D, it's a precursor to collagen production. So precursor to rebuilding your cells, tissues, and organs of your joints, and even in the heart and things like your lungs. So you need those collagen molecules to be properly introduced with the building blocks it needs to create healthy tissues.
Yeah, so vitamin C, vitamin D, two major factors of what we wanna have. Zinc. I remember when we were younger, our dad used to have, like, he's obsessed with zinc when it comes to a cold, and I never really understood. I thought he was just crazy. But zinc is amazing. It says it may help reduce the duration of your sickness by 33%. I was reading one study, and I was talking about if you take this within 48 hours of your onset of your symptoms coming up, this is when it drops down your like 4 days it takes off having your sickness. So it gets rid of your symptoms almost immediately. So this is something that you want to take. I personally like to take this in a liquid form because I know that that's the most readily available as far as your system. We do actually have both a liquid and a pill version of this. Again, either one is great, but I really like the liquid version the best.
Zinc is not produced in the body, so you need to take it from an outside source through your food or through supplementation. If you're taking it through supplementation, not just any zinc is okay. You've got to make sure it's readily bioavailable, mm-hmm. and the products that we have on the shelf are readily bioavailable, and they get into the system quickly.
Yeah, I mean, zinc, it tastes a little funky when you take the liquid stuff, but it's something that you get through really
easily. I just remember Dad used to make us take that stuff like buckets when we were getting sick.
Zicam or whatever it was.
Adjustments and zinc.
Yeah. And I didn't know, like I said, I didn't understand why I was getting adjusted, and I didn't understand why we were taking zinc, but our parents knew the difference, and that's what we did, and it paid off in the end, because neither one of us had any medications. Elderberry, echinacea, and other herbs. Let's talk about elderberry, because this made a huge coming out party last year. I think everybody and their brother started making elderberry syrup. One of my best friends is a huge advocate for elderberry. I remember when we go on vacation, she'll make sure that she gets a thing of elderberry syrup because she wants to take it while she's there to boost her immune system so we don't get caught up with any funky things that we're going to be coming in contact with or being somewhere else. Elderberry, really, the only thing it is, it's just a deep purple fruit that gets crushed up. There's things like vitamin A, vitamin E, vitamin C in elderberry, and that's why it's such a good thing to be taking when your body's sick. It's got the natural vitamin C in there to help with your system symptoms. Another thing is echinacea. This is Dr. James's one of his favorite plants. Mm-hmm. You'll often see him, especially in this time right now, chasing people around in our office to take the echinacea. And it's the one that we have is an alcohol base, and it's like the worst supplement ever.
I like it.
I'm just not a fan of like stuff. I do it because I know it's good, but I'm just like, it's not fun for me.
So something I learned about echinacea back at a seminar was that if it doesn't make your tongue numb, then it's probably not good. It's not a good source of echinacea. So taking that stuff and getting that numbness is a really good sign that your echinacea is from a good source. And that's what happens.
That's exactly what happens.
With our echinacea.
I'll be planning to go into a doctor's consultation with somebody who's like, put this in your mouth. I'm like, no, I can't because I won't be able to talk.
So we've been taking echinacea for years, and now this CBD oil has come out, and it's literally blanketing the entire world right now. But echinacea and CBD oil, they've got the same constituents. They're from the same genome.
So one of the cool things about this is that you'll see our product line has expanded tremendously, and I'm so proud to stand with these supplements. The IM support, it just stands for immune support. This has things like your elderberry is in there, your echinacea is in there, vitamin C is in there. There's four different mushrooms, which you love as well. On a daily basis. These things are not even just gonna help you boosting your immune system, but it's gonna help your brain function, it's gonna help your body work. We've got vitamin D3 with probiotic. The reason why this is attached with the probiotic is because that probiotic is like an excavator. Vitamin D is actually absorbed in your gut lining. And so the probiotic goes in there, it makes a way for the D3 to actually get absorbed into the gut lining so that you can get it the best that you can. We've got vitamin C complete in a pill form, and we've also got it in a powder form, which I like to take it that way the best. And then we've got zinc plus, and then we've also got the zinc liquid.
So Dr. Kaylee, what type of person would you put on a regimen like this?
Yeah, so this is for the person who either has an immunocompromise going on, so their immune system is poorly functioning. Somebody who already has symptoms coming up, so you've got the sneezes, the sniffles, you've got the cough, the sore throat happening. Somebody who lives in a house with somebody who is immunocompromised or is developing symptoms. If you work in a hospital, if you work in a healthcare facility, if you work in a place surrounded by people who are coughing and sneezing or wearing masks and depleting their immune system. The IM support is something that I wouldn't take on a daily basis, but maybe even the zinc, but that's something that's coming in to take on a daily basis. So the D3, the vitamin C, and the zinc is something that should be taken on a daily basis and then upped when you're feeling symptoms. But the other one is something that I would bring in later.
Symptoms tell stories. We've been teaching that to patients for many years now, and you've got to just heed your symptoms, understand what they're trying to tell you. If you've got allergies every season that changes, that means your immune system is compromised. It's not working properly. So again, the body's trying to recruit these different things, techniques to get the allergens and pathogens out of the body. But again, that's your immune system not functioning properly. So that's the type of person that I would put this on.
Yeah.
You know, people that are, again, immunocompromised, cancer people, this is a good regimen for that to make sure that those cells, tissues, and organs inside can work and function properly.
So for this, maybe you're watching us virtually and you're like, how do I get access to your supplements? You can go to our website. We'll make sure we put it on here. It's Dr. Judge. maxliving.com, and we'll make sure that you, I mean, there's a whole store that you can order from, and it'll get shipped right to your house right from there. If you're a patient in our office, just come in and we'll get you set up. All right, we did it.
Yep, that's week two already. Viruses, I'm super excited to go through in detail, and it's hard to kind of hold back some information because we're going to go through a lot of information these next 5 weeks. So we're really trying to sprinkle short bursts of information throughout the 6 weeks here. But next week, I believe, is
cancer.
Cancer.
This is heavy, a heavy topic. I know that every single one of us, either speaking or listening or watching, has been affected by cancer in some form or another. And so we promise you that we are going to be very sensitive to that fact, but we also want to bring light into a dark situation.
So the fact is, we're in the middle of Cancer Awareness Month right now, and I think everyone's aware of cancer, and cancer exists all over the place, just like Dr. Keeley said, and it continues to rise every single year. And our goal is to help you understand ways to make sure that your bodies can prevent cancer, that can fight cancer off. Because just like a virus, a cancer cell is a rogue thing, a microbe inside of your body that's trying to take it over. And if your immune system can function properly, then it'll fight the virus, it'll fight the cancer, it'll fight the microbe, it'll fight anything. You literally create a titanium immune system if you align with all of the information that we're trying to teach you here today and the next couple of weeks.
So come next week with an open mind and ready to learn maybe just something new about a topic that is spoken about a ton. We just want to give you some, shed some light on this and help you through this for ourselves too. Like, I'm learning a lot as we're going through this or relearning it again. And so we just want to be a part of a team that's going to advocate for you and give you the tools that you need to become empowered to take control of your health.
All right, Keeley, so that's it. I just want to go back and recap what we started with, the Louis Pasteur germ theory of disease. On his deathbed in 1895, he said that the germ, the microbe, is nothing, and that the terrain is everything. So again, what we are giving you are tools to help you build a terrain that could never let viruses flourish, so your body can function and heal itself on its own.
So join us next week for Cancer Awareness, where we dive deeper into what we need to do to be ninjas at our health.
And becoming masters at your health.
Bye, everybody.
Peace out.
See you next week.